I have some patients ask me, I've been told I can't have implants because I don't have enough bone. Is that true? And it's true that over 50% of implants need a bone graft. So if you don't have enough bone, generally, most all of the time, the bone can be grafted so that you have adequate bone. Out of all of those implants that are required and necessary to get implants in, 80% of those grafts tend to be sinus grafts, which are a little bit more complicated. And so if you've been told you don't have enough bone, 80% of the time, you're going to need a sinus graft. That makes the top jaw, which if you were to Google that and see what the difference of the top jaw is compared to the lower jaw in strength, it would say the lower jaw is much stronger. So we're always looking to strengthen the top jaw. And the sinus graft is a beautiful way, very predictable way to do that. And what's great about the sinus graft is when you go to get the implant in, you start your pilot drill and it almost feels like styrofoam until you hit where the graft starts. And when you hit that graft with the pilot drill, it's like you just ran into a brick wall. It's like granite, oak. You're just trying to get the pilot drill in there, and you know you're going to have a rock solid anchor. It's like finding a rock solid foundation. You just have to go down until you find it. And when you do, it's really good. And so I'm always really, really impressed, especially with the full arch cases over time, where you'll get the implants in, and those sites that are grafted, the native bone will sometimes recede and resorb away. In fact, in dentistry, we, you know, used to say that it's predictable that a half a millimeter of bone will recede from the neck of an implant every year. And in fact, we just, right now, that's the standard of care. If that's happening, we're okay with that. But the field is progressing, and truly, this new implant system that has come out of the market is designed to prevent bone loss at the neck. So with this new system called platform switching, and platform switching isn't new, that's been around for at least 20 years, but this system has the most extreme platform switching. And what we've seen, which is like amazing, is that bone actually grows back up the neck over time, and rather than just going away, which is what we accept as the standard of care and normal. I think as time goes along, we're going to learn that that's no longer acceptable, just like it's no longer acceptable on teeth. And implants, as time goes along, we come to learn that, you know, implants are pretty much just like teeth. We don't accept bone loss in teeth, and we don't accept bone loss in implants either. The field's not there yet, but it's very exciting to see the progression of that. So bone grafting will, I think, really keep a case, a full arch implant supported fixed case, very strong for a long, long time. Long time. I want to say a lifetime. I'm almost on the verge of saying that, but I don't want to quite, you know, make promises blanketly to, you know, people that I don't haven't examined. But it's great. Thank you.